are very gifted at what they do. Boxers that have struggled and came up through the ranks and have illustrious careers. Daniel Valdivia is here. We are clapping for Mr. Valdivia. Of course, we know that Mr. Shane Mosley is in the room. We also have Jesse Vargas. And we also have Crystal Morales. Shannon Torres-Gilman. I talked to her tonight for a few minutes, and she touched me deeply. I'm not going to give you. Wow, that's right. Wow. I'm going to take that 2 minutes that we were talking about. What she said touched me. I'm not going to give you the specifics of the conversation, but she did tell me that her family, her daughter Chloe, is here. And Julian was very instrumental in touching her life in the last year, and I'm ever so honored that you told me that. And it means a lot to me when people talk to me about my son and how he has somehow gifted them with something. I have been out for the Stonar program, and these children, adults, young adults, if you give them the chance, they'll open up and tell you about such wonderful, beautiful things, a myriad of emotions that I've witnessed coming out of them. And so I saw that Shannon tonight was just this beautiful emotional moment that we shared. And I just want to make note of that because it was a very personal thing. Shannon doesn't know this, but I actually live near her. She grew up in Oxnard. Anybody who knows, like, Ojai versus Oxnard?
Ojai!
Yeah, I went to Matilaha and then Nordoff. And you know that place, huh? If people don't know that, yeah.
I know.
Yeah, right on. The Ojai people look down on the people in Ventura and Oxnard. And it's true. I mean, we had Miners Oaks that was looked down upon time. Well, I won't go into that. Upper Ojai, which had all the walnut trees and avocados, and we had the orange trees. And I used to steal the orange and the avocados. I'd box them, and I'd take them to the local health food restaurant. And after about a month, they caught on, and I didn't steal anymore. I'm not a thief. I'm not.
You were starving.
I was starving. Thank you, Dana. This is not a Christoph St. John show, but I was forced to eat like grass for most of my life. My parents were total raw food heads. But back to Shannon. We grew up not too far from each other. She's done a lot of charity work. I found out today, I was talking to someone about horses, and I didn't know this, but horses love to play with balls. And that's interesting to me because who would have thought that? We see dogs and cats, but they have this affinity for playing. And that kind of ties in, it does, with charity work that Shannon has done. She's worked with horses to help children, people that the horses have nurtured and they nurture back. I got on a horse one time and basically fell off. So anyone who works with horses, you gotta be a strong person. I'm going to introduce two people who are going to come up and present Shannon Torres-Gilman with the Humanitarian Award. And because Shannon has done so much work for others, domestic violence is a huge issue, not just in this country, but globally. I'm sure we all have someone in our lives who has been touched by that issue. Women who have, in effect, been helpless, defenseless, and in the program that Shannon has been a part of, they are taught to defend themselves. They are taught to stand up for themselves, to have pride in who they are, and to not let men or anyone disservice them or hurt them. These are just a couple of the charity foundations that Shannon has helped, that Shannon is spearheading. Jill Diamond has come tonight. Where are you, Jill?
Jill,
there you are. Jill Diamond, you can come up. That's okay, I'm gonna give you a little. She works WC Cares Foundation. You heard Mia say that they very generously contribute to this foundation. She's gonna be presenting this award with Jackie Callen. Now, Jackie, we know from Against the Ropes, all right? So come on up. Meg Ryan played Jackie in the film. And that was news to me. I found that out tonight. Mia told me, and I was like a kid in a candy store, so. Jill and Jackie, I'm gonna turn this over to you to present the Humanitarian Award to Shannon Torres-Gilman.
There's just so many times in your life that you meet one, two, maybe three people that actually make a difference in other people's lives. And I feel very blessed to have met Shannon. He's like a guiding light for others. She shines. She makes life better. People, animals, children, everywhere she goes. Facing her own obstacles, she hasn't stopped. She just keeps on giving. So I feel very honored to be up here with Jackie to help present this award. Jackie?
Well, it's always good to be with you, Jill. We go back a long way.
Girl power, girl power.
But when Mia called me and asked if I would come here to present this award, I couldn't get out of the plane fast enough. First of all, because I love Mia and respect her. We go back a long, long way. And women, and I'm sure men too, but women, and even in this business, I think it's a little more so than in others, but we're there for each other. When I opened up a gym several years ago in South Central for kids there, Mia and Paris were there. And we do things to support each other and give back to the community, because it's not what you get out of this world, it's what you give back to this world that defines who you are. And what struck me about her, we can all read her story, it's on the table, we know her background. You know that she grew up in Oxnard with her grandparents, and how much her grandfather meant to her. He was a boxer, a Golden Gloves boxer, really taught her to love this sport. And then there's the adversity, which all of us have faced. And her and I have a lot in common. You know, she's battled cancer, so have I. She's battled domestic abuse, so have I. Mental health issues, every family's touched by that. I don't know anybody who hasn't been touched by any of those things. And the sad part about mental illness is that it doesn't always show. And the person who has an illness like cerebral palsy or muscular dystrophy, you see it and you feel bad and you want to do something. But so many of the people around us who are suffering from mental illness, they're the best looking people and they look like they got it all together. And they're the ones that need help the most. We just don't see it. So an organization like Mia's, which brings attention to the situation and makes us all aware that there's no shame to that game. There's no lack of pride in who you are just because you have a mental illness. We just have to be there to help these people, make their life more meaningful. And I'm so proud to also be in the same room as Shane Rosa, because we go back many, many years. We did a little movie together about 15 years ago, and we've just been good friends, and it shows how strong the bonds in boxing are. Because in and out of the ring, we're all fighting. We're fighting for acceptance, we're fighting for love. And most of all, we're fighting to make this world a better place. And Shannon, you make this world a better place. And I'm so honored, and so is Jill, to ask you to come up here and accept these awards. Because this room is filled with love for you.
Thank you.
Louder.
I don't know, don't come like closer. So, yeah, first I just want to thank Mia, Christoph, and thank you, Paris. Because I know it was your decision who this was going to, and it doesn't for one second weigh heavily with me the fact that not only is it Julian's birthday, but this is his first kind of award that you're giving, and that alone is just so touching. Mia and my friendship kind of began in Colonia, if you want to know the truth. I actually did grow up in Oxnard. I grew up in a very bad part of Oxnard called Lemonwood. Most people wouldn't go in there. Famous game, learn how to ditch a drive-by. Good to know, just don't want to live there. The one thing I didn't realize when I was growing up there was for as much as people don't want to know people from Oxnard or people from Colonia and Lemonwood, my neighborhood where I was, we weren't aware of it. If you were hungry, somebody gave you food. If you were sick, somebody prayed for you. And if you didn't have parents, somebody was there to take care of you. That's probably the foundation that stands with me the most. What Christoph doesn't know is in my teenage years, I was actually moved to Ojai when my mother decided she wanted to try parenting. Not a good choice. I was accepted into the community for the way I looked. But as soon as they would realize where I was from, what my background was, and what my accent was at that time, I was instantly picked on and bullied. So much so that I would dread every single day walking in feeling like the oddest person in the room. I think that where I'm coming from in my life now, I would hope, is from a space of to learn every single day that it's not about me, it's about we. That it's not about what's going wrong with me or how my day's going, but it's about whether or not I can affect somebody else's day. Because the high I get from that is life. It's incredible. In the phone call with Mia on Halloween, the things we said to each other were raw. They were emotional, and they were two mothers talking to each other, not just two friends. And nothing I've ever done felt like I wanted acknowledgement for it or comfort from it. It was always just so I could be authentic. Like Paris said, I'm just trying to be me. I fail miserably sometimes. I catch myself sometimes. But I always pick myself back up when I think I can't, and I try harder. Every time I fall, I find a reason. I told me, I said, you keep raising the bar. Just when you told me you couldn't go on anymore, and I was ready to agree, all of a sudden, there she is again, raising the bar. As much as you're giving me this award, in my heart, this award is yours always. Because you're always raising the bar for me. And our friendship has been amazing for me. It's acceptance. It's an individual connection. And it's a loving family, from our children to everything we do. I have to thank my family. John has always supported me. As he told me, his psychotically loyal wife recently. He says, I don't get you. Everything you go through, and you're just always there. I put you through hell. You're just always there. I said, I choose to take that as a compliment. Because I'm going to be here. My little brother, who I have always tried to help to excess, probably helicoptering a little bit. Nobody would deny that.
But trying to show him that just because of where we come from, what we are, or how messed up our family has been, that it's okay. Everybody's messy. Everybody's got that. You can embrace it, you can move on, or you can fall. I'm not gonna fall. I'm not gonna allow anybody I know to fall. And that's my mission, because it helps me. Maggie, years ago, when I first met her, the reason why she's here is I had been helping her out with some physical therapy, and we connected very strongly. I got hit by a car and couldn't walk. I thought, once again, I'm on my knees, my life is over, this is it. I don't know how to pick myself up. Maggie was at my door with chicken soup, telling me to come on because we had to go work at the homeless shelter. I said, Maggie, I can't walk, and she says, I'll wait. And she did. I limped, had them waiting up behind me, crawled, whatever it took to get to that homeless shelter, and I realized life wasn't so bad for me still. I was going to get up. It was going to be okay. It was going to be some work, and that's all right. My point of this, in telling you all of this, really, is just to say that this award truly does touch me. Paris, you totally motivated me and inspired me. I hope that I find a way to always do something more and something better out of the courage that I've seen from all of you. And I truly do appreciate it. The morals and the values that I learned from my grandparents have gotten me through a lot in my life. I've learned that life's not always fair, and sometimes you're going to have a lot, sometimes you're going to have nothing, but you always have yourself to give. And sometimes when I have a lot, I give, and sometimes when I have nothing, I show up. And I think if there's a message for anybody to tell anybody, it's that. You don't have to obtain things to do good, because you are good and you can do good through that. So I truly appreciate this. And I'll leave with all your heart.
Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. Take a step back.